Hello students, we have already completed about DC potentiometer details and the application of DC potentiometer. We can tell that actually potentiometer is of two types, DC and AC. Actually, a potentiometer is an instrument which measures unknown voltage by balancing it with a known voltage. The known source may be DC or AC. The working phenomenon of DC potentiometer and AC potentiometer is same, but there is one major difference between their measurements. DC potentiometer only measures the magnitude of the unknown voltage, but the AC potentiometers measures both the magnitude and phase of unknown voltage by comparing it with a known reference. So we can come to the classification of AC potentiometer. AC potentiometer is mainly of two types, polar type and coordinate type. And whatever I told is written in your slide, that DC potentiometer only measures the magnitude of unknown voltage, whereas an AC potentiometer measures both the magnitude and phase of unknown voltage by comparing it with known reference. Clear to you about the DC and AC. Now we will go in the classification of AC potentiometer. First of all, we will study what is polar type potentiometer. In this potentiometer, the magnitude of the unknown voltage is measured from one scale and its phase angle is directly on the second scale. The arrangement is made to read phase angles up to 360 degrees. The voltage is read in the form of V angle theta. This is a phasor diagram of polar type potentiometer. Whatever main important of polar type potentiometer is, we have to study in details about how the polar type potentiometer functions. So we are taking one example, and the name of the example is Drysdale type AC potentiometer. Okay, so we will go in details. The circuit diagram you can see in the slide. Here, two separate scales are used to measure magnitude and phase angle on some reference of the unknown EMF. There is a provision on the scale that it could read phase angle up to 360 degrees. You can see it, right? It has electrodynamometer type ammeter along with DC potentiometer and phase shifting transformer, which is operated by single phase supply. You can see here that the supply is given from there, right? In phase shifting transformer, there is a combination of two ring shaped laminated steel stators connected perpendicularly to each other as shown in the slide. One is directly connected to the power supply, and the another one is connected in series with the variable resistance and capacitor. You can see it, that one is directly connected with the supply and another one is connected across the supply in series with the resistance and capacitor. The function of the series components is to maintain constant AC supply in the potentiometer by doing small adjustments in it. Between the stators, there is laminated rotor having slots and winding which supplies voltage to the slide wire circuit of the potentiometer. When current start flowing from the stators, the rotating field is developed around the rotor, which induces an EMF in the rotor winding. This is the rotor, you can see. Okay. The phase displacement of the rotor EMF is equal to rotor movement angle from its original position, and it is related to the stator supply voltage. The whole arrangement of the winding is done in such a way that the magnitude of the induced EMF in the rotor may change, but it does not affect the phase angle, and it can be read on the scale fixed on the top of the instrument. That means in the top of the instrument there will be a scale, and from there you can directly read what is its magnitude. Okay. Many times we can say that this is the scaling, and from this scaling we can read the magnitude. The induced EMF in the rotor, we are going to the next slide, right? Then it will be easy for you to understand. Study in details this slide. You will again get a clear idea about the operation of residual type potentiometer. Now we are coming that the induced EMF in the rotor winding by stator winding, one can be expressed as U1 equals to K into I sine omega t into cos theta. You can mark this equation as equation number one. The induced EMF in the rotor winding by the stator winding two, we can express as E2 equals to K into I sine of omega t plus 90 degree cos of phi plus 90 degree. Okay. So what we can write it? Minus KI cos omega t sine phi, right? From the equation number 1 and 2, that is from this equation and from this equation, we can come in the conclusion that E equals to KI sine omega t cos phi minus cos omega t sine phi. Therefore, the resultant induced EMF in the rotor winding due to two stator winding is E equals to KI sine omega t minus phi, where phi gives the phase angle. So, from the scale that is on the top of the instrument, you can directly read the magnitude, and from this equation, you will get the value of the phase angle. So, in this way, the Drysdale type potentiometer works. Thank you. If you have any queries, study in details and ask me questions upon this topic.